First, let's look at how we're going to use the decode method. It's going to return a string with the decoded message, and it doesn't need any arguments. So in the decoder tester, we want to print out the result of decoder.decode. The decoder was made with the coded messages string already in it, so we don't need to pass that string in again. Now back to the decoder itself. We need to write a for loop that reads every 10th letter, starting with the 0th one. Since we're reading a string, we want to go as long as the index is less than the length of the string. Encoded message is the string that we're reading. And instead of incrementing by 1 at a time, I'm going to increment I by 10 every time, so that we only see every 10th letter. Inside the loop, the part that I want to repeat is reading the ith letter and adding it to decoded message. So decoded message will be itself plus encoded message.substring from I to I plus 1. Remember, this is how we got one letter out of a longer string. Let's see if this works. Looks like there are more secret messages in here. If you're curious what they are, I guess you'll have to try starting at different indices. Let me talk for a moment about a couple of bugs that you might have encountered. If you accidentally wrote less than or equals to right here, like this, you might encounter a string out of bounds exception when you try to access too high of an index in encoded message. A string index out of bounds exception is a runtime error. That particular runtime error is nice because it stops the program and tells you you tried to access a value that doesn't exist, which is much better than silently messing up your program's result. You could correctly, though a little clumsily, write the condition as I is less than or equal to encoded message.length minus 1. That would work, but I don't think it's as clean. When you iterate over a string, it's best to go as long as I is less than the length.